All right, welcome to another edition of Painting with Red. We're going to paint a winter scene today, maybe have a cabin in it. Hope you'll like it. Limited on the colors, not a whole lot of colors we're going to use. But if you want to paint with us, I'm going to use naturally titanium white, Mars black, and a little burnt umber, and a little bit of alizarin crimson in a couple of places. Mostly going to be white because it's a winter scene. I hope you'll enjoy it. So let's get right to it. Now, I've covered the canvas, prepared the canvas. I got a coat of liquid white because, you know, we do the wet on wet technique. So I got a coat of liquid white on the canvas right now. So what we're going to do is we're going to start out with a little black. Get just a little black in the paintbrush. Go over and get a little blue and put in it. Black and blue, mostly black. We got black and blue. That's what we're going to put in the brush today. And we're going to start up here in the sky. I got a hair on the brush. We're going to start up here on the sky, and we're just going to start using our little crisscross strokes. And we're going to go across and make a pretty little sky. And that's too much. Let's get a little blue in there. Let's just blend this on out. I'm going to purposely leave a few little places in here that's white because we don't want the whole sky to be solid. So as we blend out, it's picking up this white on the back of that, I mean the white, the liquid white that's on that canvas, mixing with a little of that blue. Brush strokes out. There we got a nice, pretty little sky going in there. Now, you won't just grab just a little bit of alizarin crimson. We're going to kind of pop a little of that right in here. Not too much, just a little bit. We're gonna kind of break up that sky a little bit. Now we got a nice dark little sky. Let's go back into that Prussian blue. Get a little bit more blue on the color. A little bit of white. Just kind of brighten it up a little bit. I'm going to come down in here and go straight across. We're just going to kind of dull this color in just a little bit. I remember that phthalo blue. It's kind of working in down here. Just kind of blocking the bottom off down here, so we're going to cover most of this anyway. Just kind of darken it in, because if you make a dark background, the light colors will show up to it. Like I said, I'm going to make a winter scene today with a little snow and stuff in the background. Now, let's get our washout brush out. Now, got the brush all dry. Let's get the palette out. Clean us off a spot where we can work with. Yeah. All right, let's take the old fan brush. Take the old fan brush. And go right into this titanium white. So get a lot of color on the brush. Really load the brush with the color. With the paint. Now, we're going to come up in here and put a few clouds in here. Of course, you got to have clouds. Just take your fan brush in the corner of the fan brush and kind of just start swirling around in here like this. Maybe there's a cloud comes out down in here. Kind of like this here. Maybe it goes back up in here like this. Push that brush up. And let those little things happen on it. Just kind of push that brush up like that right there. See what I'm talking about? And go right back into that white. Maybe there's some clouds that live right up in here like this. Kind of bring your brush down in there. You know, you can make straight lines, you know, not all clouds are shaped exactly the same way, so you don't need to shape them exactly the same way. I'm going to put a little paint thinner on here, just a little bit, kind of thin this paint down just a little bit. Maybe there's a few that go right in here. You know, just make them crisscross places. Little swirls and things, and you'll get the idea. When you do it enough, you can get the idea about what a cloud looks like. All right, now, I think that's enough clouds. Clean the brush out. Now, let's take your dry 2-inch brush and down at the bottom, take the corner of the brush and just down at the bottom, base of these clouds, just start making some swirly edges. Kind of blend all this in. Now that blends in and just makes that sky blend in together there. See how that makes it go together there? Gently lift up, kind of fluff these clouds up a little bit. See how that looks? And you can just bring all that together and get the brush strokes out. Now we got, I think we got a pretty nice looking little winter sky. Clean the brush out. Now we want to take, let's take a little, let's get a little black, a little blue, maybe a little lizard crimson, a little blue, and put a little white in it. Just kind of blend all that together. A little more white in it. Yeah, I want to get some blue color. Mix more toward the blue. We're just getting a good old mixer of gray, kind of bluish gray color. That's all I'm doing. A little more white in there. Kind of blue that up. Kind of get a good gray color. That's what we want, just a good gray mixture of. Let me pick this up and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Just get a good gray, bluish looking color. Mix it up real good on the palette. Next, take that fan brush, and here's what we're going to do. We're going to really load that fan brush with some of that color. This is a winter scene. You got to think cold and dark. Really load that color on that brush. You get a lot of color in it. Maybe there's some trees that live right in here. So I'm going to go right in here. Take the corner of the brush and we're going to push upward. Start a little at the top. And just make your way down. See there? Go back into that color. We're gonna give him a friend over here. See there? Give him a friend over there. Maybe there's some right over here. Maybe there's some right over here. Now you get harder and harder as you come down the tree. Harder and harder and further out wide as you come down the tree. Got another little buddy, a little shorter than him, lives right over in here. Like that right there. Something like that right there. Maybe there's one more lives right over here. A little smaller one, maybe right in this corner right here. We'll just drop down in there with him, right there in the trees in the background. Now, clean the brush. Now, take a dry 2-inch brush. And now we're going to start right in here. We're just going to make this look like a lot of mist back in here. So what you want to do is start tapping at the base of these old trees and pick up some of that color. And just kind of go right down in here like this right here. We're going to make a lot of mist back in here. Put this in the background. Put all this in the background. Push all that back in the background. Maybe this is trees back up out in here. You just can't hardly see in the background. Yeah, mist in. Looks like fog and mist in the background. If you want, you can take some of that color. Maybe add you a few little trees and bushes that live right along in here. Just kind of tap along in that color, and maybe there's a few live over here. Don't just put it on there at random. Just think about the texture of what a tree might look like. Maybe there's some that live right over in here. Anywhere you can think of. Just misty in the background. Now, all that stuff's in the background. You can't get much detail. You don't want to see that much. So you ain't got a whole lot of detail in the background. As you come forward with it, you have more detail. Clean off my knife. Now, what we're going to do, I was thinking about putting a cabin in here. So what we're going to do, right in here, we're going to figure out where this cabin's going to be. And we're just going to scrape this excess paint out. Well, maybe not a cabin. Let's put a barn. So you got to get the outline going about what you want to do. Figure out where you want to put it. Now we're going to go into some brown. Put a little bit of black in it. Just dull it down a little bit. Darken that color up. Cut across, get a little roll of paint. Like I said, we're going to have us maybe a barn right in here. So you need to come straight across about where you're going to go. Let's put the back E with this more. Maybe it's gonna be right here. Always go out with your shape first, and then you can, with your edges first, kind of give you a little outline of where you're gonna go. That way your lines will be straight when you go to make them. What we're gonna do is we're just getting some basic color in it right now. That's all we're gonna do. Come on. Straight down with some color. We're just blocking this out. We're not gonna worry about the bottom of it right now because we'll take care of that when it gets to it. You can always straighten the edge of it out when you get down there. Maybe we got a little edge that comes off down here. In the barn in. Maybe you got a little, let's make we got a little thing comes off down here on this side too. Don't worry about the bottom right now. We just scrape that excess paint off. Get right in here with some titanium white. Get that rolling paint on it. Like I said before, in the snow, make your line across. Broke down the edge of that building. Let it flow down the edge of that building. Kind of like it right there. Forget about the other side of this barn. Got the snow over it. Let's bring that one out here like this here. First off, get that edge straight over here. See like that right there? Then you can come back with a little snow just like that right there. anything, you move this paint any which way and anywhere you want to. Let's get a little bit of brown down here. A little bit of brown down here. Some barns out there. Been out there a long time. Really push that paint, that knife against that canvas. Really push it down in there. Well, we're about the bottom of the barn. We'll get that off in a minute. Let me put a little bit of right in here. Kind of separate that roof on that barn. Let me wipe my knife off a little bit more. Straighten that edge up just a little bit. All right, let's take a little. Let's take a little white. Get a little bit of brown. Just kind of mix it together a little bit. We're gonna make a little marbled like. Color, get a little more brown and put in there, and we're just gonna don't mix it too much. Let me get my knife cleaned off, got a little wrong color on it. Okay, now we're gonna kind of highlight this old barn a little bit. Before I do that, let's take a little of this black. It's kind of. Let's take a little of this black and brown here. Mix it real good. A little color. We're going to kind of separate the corners of these boards a little bit. Kind of like put a little post or something in there. Just kind of give it a little contrast. All right, now. Let's take a little of this brown color that we got on the knife. What we're gonna do is we're gonna make this look like, gonna come up here and make this look like old border. So we're just gonna barely touch it and come down. Gonna give it a little highlight on it there. Just to make just a little bit darker on this side, so don't put much on there. You want that to be just a little bit darker. fix this. All right, let's take a little of this dark color. Let's make a few boards in it. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go in just a touch. Maybe we got the indication of a few boards. Barely touch. Just touch real lightly like some old boards off in the distance. Just give a little indication of maybe some boards just put in there. Take a knife and just come down there on these. Take your knife and just make these things look all kinds of weathered and old. It's like an old barn that's been standing out here for ages and ages. A little more brown on this side. Right there. It's like this old barn that's been standing out there forever. All right, let's put a little more snow on that top. I like a little more snow to be on that top. So I'm gonna get a little more white. And we just gonna put a little bit more snow on the tops of those. That little barn. That white. Pull it out straight. Let's go up here and put a little more snow on the tops of this old barn. Just inspect that right there. Just like that right there. I mean, you can even come sideways if you want to. That helps with it. You can just come sideways if you wanted to. Bit on the side back there. Now, take a little bit of this black. We're just gonna come up in here. Kind of indicator. These little borders. Maybe sitting in here. Put those borders back in there. Maybe this. Gotta have a way to get in the barn. So, take a little more of that black. Gotta have a way to get in that barn. So, let's take a little more of that black. Let's make us a door in that barn. Come right in. See how easy it is to make a door? Just drop it in there. That's how they get in that old barn. Maybe this old barn's got a... Maybe this old barn's got a loft in it. Maybe this old barn's got a little window up here. If you want, you can take this color, a little white, let's get a little white. Just a little bit. I'm going to kind of highlight the side of these doors, kind of make them. Make it stand out a little bit more. A little bit like that, maybe. All right, now we can come along here. Just kind of take the bottom of this barn, cut it off. Just like it right there. Just scrape it off. Scrape that excess paint off. Now what we're going to do, we're going to take the titanium white. Get a lot of brush, a lot of paint on the brush. Really dig that paint down in there. Alright, we're going to come along here and start making some snow. Just kind of grab that color on that barn. Really get down in that barn. Color it come across like that right there. Takes lots of white to make that snow show up. It looks just like it snowed deep in the wintertime. Straight up in by these trees and just come straight down. Don't worry about it. We can straighten them edges up in a minute. Really get it in, like it was really blown in here. Heel comes right down in here, like that right there. Right down in front of that old barn. Clean the brush out. All right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that fan brush again. Get a little paint thinner on the brush and get some white. what we're gonna do is we're gonna kind of make these edges, kind of straighten these edges up over here. Streak it down in here. Kind of make it look like that wind that just blew that snow all down in that hill. And we come down in there with it snow and just make it look like it's add a little of that paint thinner to it. It makes that paint thinner and it'll stick on top of that paint, that thicker paint that's under it, and make all these pretty little streaks. Look like snow drifting. You can get a little bit of hint of ground down under it. All right, now what we're gonna do is go back into that gray color that we had, that darker gray color. Maybe there's a tree that's right here. Look into that guy. Just kind of thin dark tree just live right down in him. All the way down against this old barn, maybe. If you want, we can go a little bit of that, get a little bit of that white color. A little bit of that white down in here. It's gonna make that tree show up a little better. Little highlight against it. Put little highlights on these old trees back in the back. Don't cover up all your darks because that's what gives you that highlight color. Turn your brush around. Use it all on one side of the brush. Just turn it around and go to the other side. And don't forget about this little tree back here. See there? Now, back up in that gray color. It's kind of come down in here and scratches a path out. Maybe there's a little path you can barely see down in here. It comes down in here like it, kind of like this here. Pulls on off the canvas like that right there. Gotta have a place for them to get in the bar. It comes down like that right there. Now you can take a little, clean that brown or blue out of your brush. It's on the trees with. Go right back into some white. Take a little white. Get a little color back on there. We're going to kind of straighten this edge up for these, this path. You just kind of come right down in there with it. Bring that right over that path like that right there. Snow there. I tell you what, I like trees. This is winter time, so we're gonna take a little of that brown, a little bit more of that brown color. Just a little bit more of that brown color. A little bit more of that brown color. Maybe a little black mixed in with it. Let's get over here and mix that over here on the brush. All right, we're going to, I like old trees. It's just kind of sitting over here. Like Bob always said, this is your bravery test. So just start up here and let's bring an old tree right down here. Like that right there. He's got a little buddy that lives right in here with him. Alright. Now we take some of that paint. Clean off the brush. We're going to take a little lighter brush. Dip into that liquid, the little paint thinner on it. I want this as thin as we can get it. put a few little limbs here and there on this old tree. As thin as we can get it. Maybe there's one comes up there like that right there. This is almost the consistency of ink. Maybe that one comes off the top of him. It's winter time. There's no leaves on these trees. Center, just grab a little more paint center and go back into paint. Just put a few limbs maybe on this old tree. Maybe they come across one another. Maybe they're coming across one another. A big old limb out here. Take and roll that paint, that brush, just roll it in there and get it all thinned out. Real thin. Thin paint will stick to a thick. Always remember that. Thin paint will stick to a thick. These old trees have been out there for a long time and they're battered. It's winter time and they're asleep. All right, now we wash that brush out. Put a little highlight on this tree, old tree, shall we? Let's get down here. Put a little highlight on that tree. I'm gonna say the light's coming from this side, so we're just gonna kind of touch this old tree a little bit. Highlight on it. Take and pull your knife to the side a little bit. Touch and barely pull it. Let the canvas get what it wants. Just let the canvas get what it wants. Now, we take our fan brush with our little bit of that white color. right down in here and kind of clean up the foot. Just maybe put a few little bushes right in here that she's in the snow. You can come out here and put some too. Just right along the edge of this old tree. A few little sprigs and here and there sticking up in there. Maybe there's some right over here. In there. Put a little highlight on. Now, I think we're gonna call that a finished painting. We're gonna call that a finished. I hope you enjoyed the painting for today. As you can see, it's a pretty little winter scene. And I hope you enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed doing it.